It is indeed a pleasure to share this presentation with you today. First, let me take you through the online training platform. Thereafter, let's move on to technical analysis charts and see how it could help us in making our buy and sell decisions. Now, when you try to enter the password, you may get locked by the system. This happens when we enter a wrong password thrice. Then you need to send an email to tushan@capitaltrust.lk to reset the password. Once you click on the correct credentials, you will be taken to this screen. Now, when you are here, you will see that there are no stocks on display. You have to add stocks that you need to watch by clicking on the plus button here. When you click, you will get to this window, which you can use to add stocks of your choice. Like this, you select on that stock, then you add, and you'll get added. Now, when you press the control button and select the stocks like this, AIC, ACL, AEL, Agalavatta, and let's say Ahongalla, and press the add button, you will be adding multiple stocks at once. Now from here, let's move on to the main menu. Now in the main menu, the watch menu has screens which we frequently use, and they are custom watch, full watch equity, portfolio watch, top gainer, top 10 gainers, top 10 losers, share volumes, and top 10 turnovers. Now, if we click on the custom watch, we will be in this screen because this is the custom watch screen. Now we have updated that. Let's move on to the full watch equity. When we move on to the full watch equity, it will display or which is displayed here will give you the complete set of market information. What is displayed here is the complete set of market information. Now, if you go to the portfolio watch like this and click on your CDS number like this, it will display market information with regard to the stocks that are displayed or that are available in your portfolio. Then let's move on to the top 10 gainers. And you will see the top 10 gainers in the screen. Then you will see the top 10 losers by clicking there in the screen once you click. Then once you click on the top 10 share volumes, you will see the display over here. Then if you take the top 10 turnovers, it will be displayed here. The useful features in the market menu is the market depth window and the detailed quote window. Now the market depth window is this. You can select a stock and leave the depth of that stock like this. Further on, you can use this add tab button and select new further stocks of your choice. TJL, let's add another one, Commercial Bank. Like this. Then all these, the market depth of these three stocks will be available for you to weave and analyze the price behavior. This market depth window can be moved across this screen like this, or you can minimize and place it at the bottom of the screen like this over here. Right. Then let's move on to the detail quotes window. Now in the detail quote window, you will see many options within the same window. Now at the top, you see the trade watch. Then at the top left hand, you see the trade book. Then in the middle, you have the market depth. At the top right hand, you have the trade summary. At the left bottom, you have the high and the low prices and the total trades for week to date and the month to date. Then on the right side, you will see the high and the low prices and the total trades for year to date and for the 52 weeks. At the same time, you can use the buy and the sell button here, accessing the buy or the sell window from the detail quote window. Now, in order to understand features in the order window, let's go. First of all, let's close this window and let's go to the buy window and let's start entering an order. The CDS account first. Of course, in your platform, you will have the CDS account, by default. And then let's select the security code. Let's say Access Engineering. Then the quantity. Then the price. You must not change the minimum fill box. It has to remain as it is. Then you can disclose a quantity as long as it is larger than 10% of the total quantity you have entered. Now the total quantity is 2000, 10% or 200 or a higher value, a higher quantity can be entered in this. Then the TIF box is the time in force that you need, you would want the order to be available, right? TIF stands for time in force. Now by default, this is a day order. Then we have a GTD order. GTD means good till day. This you can use if you are entering an order for more than 1 day, but less than 5 days. By using this, you can keep the order valid for 2, 3, or 4 days. Now the next TIF order type is GTC. GTC is good till cancel. A GTC order is valid for 5 straight days. This can be used if you're entering orders after trading hours, like what we are doing now. So I'm going to leave this order, the TIF order type, as GTC. Then we are moving on to this side, to the buying power. Now the buying power is an excess purchasing power given to you against your existing balance and your portfolio value. This facility is given for you to use that amount to purchase shares and settle us on or before 9 a.m. of the settlement date, which is T plus 3. That is 3 days from the date of purchase. Now the margin trading holders need to know that the buying power given in the system is not the buying power value they need to follow. Instead, they need to follow the buying power given by the margin trading provider. Now, once you check on your buying power, or before entering the order, you need to check on the buying power to see whether you have enough funds to enter the order. Now, once that is decided, you can move down to order value and check the figure there, the commission, and then the net value. You can see the amount that you will be spending if you buy this stock at this price. Then you click on the buy button here, and the system will ask you to confirm. You must, and it is important to check the figures or the data that you have entered, whether they are right or wrong, and then you click on the yes button. Once you enter the order, it goes into the orders menu and to the feature called order blotter. Now in this, you can see here the order is displayed. It is in queue. Now this can be changed. This order can be changed by using the buttons over here. Now this button at the corner, left hand corner, is the amend button. Then the button in the middle is the cancel button. And the other one is a history button. Now at the same time, you can right click and do the same features. In this case, since we used this order as a demonstration, we are going to cancel the order. Now from here, let's move on to the client menu. In the client menu, we are going to see the account statement, the portfolio, and the account summary. When we click on the account statement, you will come into the account statement where the purchases, sales, payments, and receipts are made or displayed. This account statement can be saved and downloaded as an Excel sheet. Then moving on to the portfolio. Here, you will see the stocks that you own in the portfolio. And the important columns in this portfolio that we need to understand are, the first one is the average price. Now the average price is the purchase price plus the commission or the brokerage for that particular purchase. Here it is 26.49. Then the BES price is the break-even sale price. Now over here you can see 26.79 as the break-even price. This gives you the value that you can sell at without a loss. If you sell at this price, you will not incur a loss. Then the total cost price is the multiplication of the quantity by the average price. Then you see the trade price column, that is the last traded price for that particular stock. Then the market value. The market value is the value or the multiplication of the quantity by the market or the traded price. Then you come to holding percentage market value. Now this is the portfolio allocation in terms of a percentage, which will be useful to analyze and rebalance your portfolio. Then the next column is the sales proceeds column, which is important. The sales proceeds means the net amount you receive when you sell a stock or the portfolio. Next in the client menu, we move on to the account summary. Before that, let's close this. We move on to the account summary. Now in the account summary, it gives you a snapshot of all the important values relevant to your CDS account, right? The cost of the portfolio is the amount you have invested so far. Market value is the present value of the portfolio. Gain loss is the difference of the above. Then the cash balance is the balance in the account statement. Then the buying power is the same as that which was explained earlier in the buy order window. Now, if you have already entered buy orders, they will be shown here as pending buy orders value. Now, if you are entering multiple orders, this window will show you as to how much you have already allocated for pending buy orders and how much more is left. Now, from here, let's move on to the mobile version of the A-Trend. Once you click on the mobile version or log into the mobile version, this is the default screen that you come into. But in order to look at the options available, let's click on the More button. In the More button, at the left-hand top corner, you see the account summary, and the account summary is the same as the function or the feature that we just now explained in the web version. Now, the difference in the mobile version is that you cannot just, you know, click on a back tab to go to the previous page. You need to use these buttons at the bottom. The buttons at the bottom are the ones that you need to use in order to navigate through the system. Now we come back to the More button, and if you click on the top stocks, you will see the top 10 stocks as per gainers, losers, turnover, and share volume. Then you come back again to the More button. You click on the More button, and in that you see many other options, and you can see the buy order and the sell order buttons are also available in this screen. So let's now enter a sell order and see how it works. You select the stock that you want to sell. And you will decide on the price that you want to sell that at. Then you can see the available shares, the quantity is 1,000 shares. Then once you click on this, you will see the order value, the commission, and the net value. Now, in the case of the TIF, the same features are available, the day GTD and the GTC orders. Since we are using or entering this order after trading hours, we are going to use the GTC order and click on the sell button. Then a message pops up. In order to confirm it, we check the details, whether it's right or wrong, especially the quantity and the price we will be looking at and the security that we want to sell. Then we press yes. Then in the mobile version, immediately you come to the order list. In the order list, you will see the sell order that we just now entered is appearing. And at the right hand corner, you see this forward arrow. And you click on that, you can change the order just like in the order blotter. Now here we are going to cancel the order because it was just for study purposes. Okay. Go to cancel. Sorry, you can't amend this order. Why is that? Sorry, that was not the order that we queued. That was an early order. Now the queued one is this. We cancel that order. Then it's done. Right. Then we come back to the More button, and we are now going to switch to the web version. Like this. Now in the menu bar, let's go to the analysis menu and select advanced charts, because now we are going to use charts in order to set up a strategy to initiate, buy and sell based on the strategy. Right here, as you enter the advanced chart feature, the moment you click on it, you come into an empty chart area. Here in this box, you have to select the box and click on the stock that you want, like this, and then you will get the data of the stock loaded into the screen. Now for this presentation, I have already prepared two charts, Access Engineering and Tokyo Non-Voting. Now, as far as fundamental analysis is concerned, you can choose a basket of shares to buy or sell. By using technical analysis by using technical indicators, let's see how we could set up a strategy which will help you to decide on the timing of your buy and sell. The reason is that you would want to follow a strategy, or the reason that you want to follow a strategy is to prevent you from behaving emotionally. It completely stops your human weaknesses to interfere with your trading. In this chart, we are going to use the PSAR, the RSI, and the MACD indicators. The PSAR indicator, as you can see here, appears as a series of dots, either above or below the price, like what we can see here, above and below the price. Depending on the direction, the price is moving. A dot is placed below the price when it is trending upward, and above the price when it is trending downward. When it is trending upwards, the dot is below. When it is trending downwards, the dot is above. MACD line, which is this blue line in this MACD indicator, triggers when it crosses above the red line, which is a signal, or which is an indication for you to initiate a buy position. Now, when the MACD line crosses below the signal line, which is a red line, that helps you to initiate a sell position. When the RSI value in this RSI indicator is above, or is of value is of 70 or above, it indicates that a security is becoming overbought or oversold and may lead for a trend reversal or corrective pullback in price. An RSI reading of 30 points or below indicates an oversold or undervalued condition. At the trend reversal point, which is here if it is oversold, and which is here if it is overbought, you can decide whether you want to start buying or start selling. Let's look at the strategy as follows. When the MACD line crosses above the signal line, then the RSI must cross above 50 points, and the PSAR dot has to be below the price line, then you initiate a buy. When the MACD blue line is below or moving below the red line, and the RSI is moving below the 60 points, and the PSAR is above, the dot is above the price, you initiate a sell. Now, I have in green vertical line, I have highlighted the area that all these three conditions were met to buy. Similarly, when all three conditions were met, it was sold, completing a trade. Now you can see there are two plus trades, and in other words, two winning trades and one losing trade by using this strategy. Within this period, the chart is showing that's roughly over a year. And if you can see the price difference, now here, the price range was between 1210 and 1270. Here, the range was 1920 to 1990. So that's a difference of a little over 7 rupees. In the case of this trade, the price, purchase price was between 1830 and 1930. Then here, the sale price was between 2170 and 2250, roughly about 3 or little over 3 rupees. Now here you can see the buy range would have been between 1990 and 2080, whereas the sell had been between 1950 and 2060, about a rupee loss there. So here you have gained 10 rupees while losing 1 rupee here. Now, adhering, sticking to this without allowing your emotions or your weaknesses to react, right? Simply by following the strategy, you have sold it here and avoided the steep fall that we can see here. Right, that is the essential part of a strategy. Now, in the case of the Tokyo price action also, we can see this green vertical lines are the buy and the sell areas for each trade. And there had been 1, 2, 3, 4 trades. And the first trade has given a profit of 9 rupees, a little over 9 rupees. Then here it's 6 rupees. Then here about 2 rupees and 60 cents, but a loss of 20 cents here. If the loss was taken and respected the strategy, that trader would have avoided this entire fall. Now that's the difference of sticking to a strategy and allowing the conditions to dictate or determine your buying and selling initiations, which in other words is helping you to control your emotions and your weaknesses. By following the strategies and looking at these two stocks, this particular strategy that we were talking about has benefited the trader. Now with that, let me conclude this presentation. Thank you very much.